Hey everyone, it's Edie, your video and YouTube strategist, and I'm coming in with a tutorial on teaching you guys or showing you guys how to use LinkedIn's new native video feature. I don't even know if that's actually what they're calling it, but LinkedIn's a little late to the game. As you know, everybody else and their brother allows you to upload videos natively to the platforms except LinkedIn, but now they're allowing this from their mobile device. Now, before you get too carried away, it's not live streaming. It's you recording your video content and then posting it onto LinkedIn, which is still good. I don't think LinkedIn personally will ever be a platform that will allow live streaming because it's such a professional platform. I mean, it's where more execs type people tend to hang out. So the likelihood of them risking the possibility of somebody saying bad things in a live stream and all that kind of stuff, I don't know if they would really be open to that, but hey, I don't know. That's my guess. So anyway, so I just wanted to come in and talk to you guys really quickly about that. This was something that was announced a few weeks back. I knew it was coming, knew that it was going to be rolled out because they had been testing it with some of their top contributors contributors on LinkedIn. And a friend of mine, Vanessa Cabrera, got an email from them today saying that, oh, she's been named as one of the, you know, since she's a LinkedIn contributor, she has access. So I go and look to see if I got an email from LinkedIn, and I didn't. So I was like, well, what the? So anyway, I decided to update my apps and went in, and lo and behold, I have the capability. So who knew? So chances are you also do. I know it was supposed to be a rollout. It was announced a while ago. I truly don't remember the exact date that I heard that it was happening, but it might be a tool that you're already using. So I just wanted to create this tutorial as I do this live and try and do this and see what it looks like and how it works. So anyway, so as you can see on my screen, I have my app, which is my LinkedIn app. So I'm going to click on that. And when you open your app, you're going to now notice that there is a video camera next to the still camera. And so that's telling you that you now have the capability of adding video. So you click on that icon and it automatically opens up for you your photos that contain video as well as photos. So I don't want to use a pre-recorded video. I want to actually create a new one. So I'm going to go here to video and then I have to turn my camera around. So I'm going to click on this icon up here to turn my camera around, and there you go. And as you can see down here, the big red button has the video camera in it, so it's ready for me to record. So I'm just going to do a really quick video. I thought I came up with the title and now I don't know what it was. Okay, I do know. So I'm just going to quickly record something just so that I can have something to post. Okay. Hi everyone, this is Edie, your video and YouTube strategist, and I'm coming in today with a question. What videos are you using to attract your ideal audience in the awareness stage or at the top of their funnel? I recommend that you use how-to videos and FAQ videos at this stage. The reason is because your ideal audience is desperate to find out the solutions to whatever their problems or issues or whatever it is that they're struggling with. And so they're looking for anything that's going to help them solve that. And typically, FAQ and how-to videos are the go-to types of videos for them to look at. You want to make sure that you keep these videos short. So make sure that they're at the most 2 minutes long, because unfortunately, we as humans have very short attention spans and we're not going to stick around really long to look at a very lengthy video. So keep the videos fairly short, keep them succinct, and answer their questions. The next thing you want to do is make sure that you're optimizing them so that they are going to be found by the people who desperately need them. If you do those two things, I guarantee you your videos are going to get seen. So anyway, if you have any questions, if you would like to share this video because you think that it is useful, please feel free to do that. And leave a comment below if you have any questions in reference to the content on this video. Thanks so much, and I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye. Okay, so my video is done. I can now, it automatically takes me to the screen where I can play it. to see how that works.
Hi everyone, this is Edie.
And I was looking at the wrong place.
And I'm coming in today with a question. What videos are you using to attract?
All right, so we see that it's fine. It's a little over a minute and a half. It's a minute and 33 seconds. And so it then automatically creates a post for you. So now all you need to do is type in there, and I'm gonna type in what videos are you using during the awareness stage that your ideal audience is experiencing. Okay. So what videos are you using during the awareness stage that your ideal audience during the awareness stage? Oh no, that doesn't make sense. During, okay. During the top of the funnel or awareness using to attract your ideal audience. Okay, so what videos are you using to attract your ideal audience during the top of the funnel, or the awareness stage? Okay. Well, oops. Period. Okay. So who might be interested? What is that? I guess I could. So you can select people, I guess, if you want. I'm not going to do that. Let's see if there's anything else. What's this button? So this is to go public if I wanted to go on Twitter and if I wanted to share it with my connections. Okay, so I'll just go public. And then I guess this is if I wanted to put anybody else on there. Okay, and then I'll just post. So,
or at the top of their funnel. I recommend that you use how-to videos and FAQ videos at this stage. The reason is because your ideal audience is desperate to find out.
Alrighty then. So that's how that looks. So that's pretty impressive. It's about time that I'm going to be the first to like it. And I'm going to comment. Oops. I'm going to comment. And I'm going to say, add an image to your comment. Sorry, that's my son. First, attempt at using the new linked in video feature on my phone. Like it. Post. Okay, so I've commented, and then let's see, do I need to share this one, anyone? I'm going to share this specifically with someone that I know. And I'll do it as, oh wait. Let's see. What do you think? This is the person that told me that she got it. It'd be nice to put a question mark. All right. Excellent. So there you go. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I look forward to seeing you guys experiment with this platform only if your ideal audience is on it. I am a proponent of really being on platforms where your ideal audience is hanging out. If they're not hanging out on LinkedIn, then this may not be a necessary evil for you. And I shouldn't call it a necessary evil, but anything with newfangled equipment and apps and whatever is like a necessary evil. So anyway, enjoy and I'll take care and see you soon. Take care. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like it, share it with your friends and colleagues, and do leave a comment below. Thanks again.